Blackstone Audio presents A Murder in Passing, a Sam Blackman Mystery by Mark de Castrique. This book is read by William Dufris. For my new grandson, Charlie, may you always have a book close at hand. Chapter 1.
So, where are we going? I asked the question as Nakayla tossed her backpack in the rear of my Honda CRV and then climbed into the front passenger seat.
I'll know in a few minutes.
She pulled her cell phone out of a belt pouch and held it in front of her like a divining rod. I shook my head with disbelief. We don't go through such elaborate secrecy on a stakeout. You'd think we were hunting international spies, not mushrooms.
Nakayla laughed. Mushrooming is serious business.
Her phone beeped.
Ooh, they're early.
I started the engine and backed down the driveway of Nakayla's bungalow in West Asheville.
You're telling me 7 o'clock on a Saturday morning is way too early.
You wanted a hobby, Sam.
She held the phone closer to her face and read the email.
Great choice. And I won't have to hear you argue with the GPS lady.
We don't argue. The woman just can't make up her mind. Always recalculating. Now, back to my original question. Where are we going?
The Kingdom of the Happy Land.
I gave her a sideways glance.
You're kidding. What the hell's that?
The only place in North Carolina ruled by a king.
What about King George?
Touché. I mean after the Revolution. It was a commune formed by ex-slaves. I didn't know anything about it until several years ago when I investigated a fraudulent insurance claim against the owners of a neighboring summer camp. We got to be friends and they told me about the kingdom. I've always wanted to see it.
And it's still functioning?
No, I think it disbanded around the late 1800s.
She looked at her phone again.
But our club president says the land is supposed to have mushrooms galore and it's private property. So, we'll get a history lesson, some exercise, and I'll fix whatever we find for dinner tonight. Much easier than cleaning a deer.
Good point. And I could probably leave my gun in the car.
Nakayla arched her eyebrows.
You brought your pistol to a mushroom club field trip?
Hey, you're the one who said there might be claim jumpers.
No. I said if we announced the location in advance, other people figure we know what we're talking about and immediately search the site.
It's hard to believe.
That people would immediately search the site?
Well, you know what you're talking about.
She gave me a jab in the ribs.
I'm the one standing between you and a poisonous toadstool. What do you say about that?
Recalculating.
Nakayla dropped the phone back in the pouch.
Smart man.
She reclined the seat a few degrees.
The site's a couple of miles below Flat Rock. We should be there in about 40 minutes.
The previous year, we'd solved a mystery involving Carl Sandburg's farm in Flat Rock, so the route was familiar. Since then, our detective agency had investigated only a handful of cases, mostly missing persons who turned out to be either runaway teens or husbands with midlife crises who left to find themselves. Our scarcity of business wasn't a financial concern. Nakayla and I each had offshore accounts funded by acquisitions, better left off the books. The Blackman and Robertson Detective Agency gave us a method for converting some of that money into reportable income. Neither of us had a desire for an extravagant lifestyle, but we did enjoy an active one. The dearth of cases had prompted my comment to Nakayla that I needed a challenge, even if it was only a hobby. And so, on a Saturday morning in May, I found myself hot on the trail of wild mushrooms. Not exactly the challenge I had in mind. Nakayla had been a member of the Blue Ridge Mushroom Club since her first job out of college. She'd gone inactive when we had formed the detective agency and our business and personal lives intertwined. As a native of Western North Carolina, she'd shown me her favorite mountain haunts and introduced me to many of her friends. I'd grown up in Central North Carolina, the section known as the Piedmont, and only came to the Appalachians for short vacations as a child when the summer heat drove my family into the hills. A rocket grenade in Iraq had taken my left leg, ended my military career as a CID chief warrant officer, and transported me to the VA hospital in Asheville for rehabilitation. The murder of Nakayla's sister had brought us together, and I found in her a kindred spirit, a partner who made me whole in a way the doctors and prosthetic devices couldn't. Although we teased and kidded.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.